Hello YouTubers, after having successfully made my first Versus series video, I was interested in continuing my foray into Star Wars and making a new video. However, this time, instead of a Versus series video, I am going to be addressing the difference between two of the Sith Order's incarnations and why one is superior to the other. First thing I will be addressing is the Rule of Two, probably the single most successful and most influential incarnation of the Sith Order. Founded by Darth Bane, the Rule of Two Sith utilized secrecy and deception as opposed to military strength in order to conquer their enemies. And that brings us to the Rule of One and the One Sith, probably the weakest incarnation of the Sith Order. They attempted to return the Sith to its ancient ways of having many Sith only loyal to its leader Darth Krayt, but in the past, while it had some minor successes, it failed every time. After the destruction of Lord Khan's Brotherhood of Darkness, Darth Bane set about to recreate the Sith Order in preparation for the eventual destruction of the Jedi and the Republic. Searching the knowledge of the ancient Sith holocrons, Darth Bane finally came across the holocron of the legendary Darth Revan. From this holocron, Darth Bane learned and adapted the idea of having only two Sith, a master and apprentice. One to embody power, and the other to crave it. This became the Rule of Two, and it would dictate how the Sith would operate for over 1,000 years, and how they would wage their war against their hated enemy, the Jedi Order. And so Darth Bane became the fabled Sithari, the man who would lead the Sith, the man who would destroy the Sith, and the man who would bring the Sith back to glory and make it stronger than ever before and ever since. And for 1,000 years, its followers, the Order of the Sith Lords, managed to maintain secrecy and plotted their grand plan that would eventually result in the end of the Republic and the Jedi Order. And in the decades prior to the Clone Wars, this plan was finally ready to be put into action under Darth Plagueis and Darth Sidious. However, Darth Plagueis, like many Sith Lords before him, had become obsessed with the idea of achieving immortality, and was preparing to cast aside the Rule of Two with this idea of him becoming the one true Sith Lord, and being able to rule the galaxy from the shadows with his apprentice, Darth Sidious, as a front. However, the will of the Sith tends to have a mind of its own. Plagueis was murdered in his sleep by his own apprentice, Darth Sidious, who had grown tired of living in the shadow of his master, and had his own aspirations for not only galactic conquest, but also for immortality. And finally, under the leadership of Darth Sidious, the 1,000-year plan of the Sith came to fruition as the Clone Wars began. And by its conclusion in 19 BBY, the Sith Order had finally wiped out the Republic and nearly driven the Jedi Order to extinction. Their reign lasting 20 years until the Battle of Endor, when both Master and Apprentice, Sidious and Vader, were killed in the destruction of the second Death Star. Despite the dissolution of the Order of the Sith Lords, the Rule of Two was more resilient than any other incarnation of the Sith had ever achieved. The cyborg Dark Lady of the Sith, Lumia, took it up and continued the tradition of the Rule of Two, training several dark apprentices over the course of her reign. The first of which was Flint, the son of a Clone Wars era Jedi Knight. Flint was eventually turned to the light side by Luke Skywalker, however, he died shortly after. Along with Karnor Jax, who died on Yencor, leaving the Dark Lady without an apprentice for over 30 years. However, her third apprentice, Darth Kydus, was probably the most successful of the post Palpatine era Sith Lords and was one of the most dangerous as well, having taken over the Galactic Alliance through legal means as well as managing to firebomb Kashyyyk and plunging the galaxy into a second civil war. The only other notable follower of the Rule of Two was Darth Red, who attempted to restore it to its use after the death of Darth Krayt in 138 ABY. And that brings us to its successor, the Rule of One and the One Sith, under the heretic Sith Lord Darth Krayt. Founded during the Yuuzhan Vong War, the One Sith remained relatively hidden to the rest of the galaxy for over 100 years, only coming out at one point during their history. During the Aboloth Crisis, Darth Krayt realized that the ancient dark side being was a serious threat to the galaxy as well as to his own plans for galactic domination, and as such intervened on the behalf of the galaxy and assisted Luke Skywalker in the final confrontation. 130 years after the Battle of Yavin, the One Sith reemerged on the galactic scene, having caused the war between the Galactic Alliance and the resurgent Empire. They sided with the Empire in order to conquer the Alliance, and eventually led to the Third Jedi Purge. Darth Krayt went on to overthrow Ronfell and was the first Sith to sit on the throne of the Galactic Empire since the death of Darth Sidious. Over the next 7 years, Darth Krayt consolidated his power and maintained his grip over the galaxy through fear and intimidation, using his skills as a Sith in order to make sure that no one would oppose him. But this was not to be, as the Galactic Alliance and Galactic Empire managed to counterattack on several fronts, including capturing a experimental Star Destroyer that would have been a powerful asset to the One Sith. Despite the fact that Darth Krayt demanded absolute loyalty, he was betrayed by Darth Warlock III, who decided that it was time for the Dreamer to die, as he said, and managed to almost kill Darth Krayt and put him into stasis, ending Darth Krayt's reign temporarily, and Darth Warlock managed to ascend to the Galactic Throne in all but title. Darth Krayt's vision of a galaxy united under the flag of the Sith was all but complete, but he had lost the way and had become more obsessed with absolute loyalty to himself and to his own power that he refused to consider the possibility that he was flawed in his own way. And he died not realizing that he had failed, because he had chosen his own path and had become obsessed with his own power. The One Sith was then taken over by Darth Nihil, who ordered them back into hiding in order to prepare for the right time to strike again at the galaxy. In concept, the Rule of Two is possibly the most simple incarnation of the Sith Order, but it was also probably the most complex. Every prior incarnation, while it had a single leader, still had massive amounts of Sith that managed to rule in one way or another. Darth Bane recognized that this was actually detrimental because it decreased the power as it was to the Sith as a whole. He said it best by saying that to share power means that it's being diluted, that it is its own purpose, and that you cannot share it that readily as many other incarnations did. Probably the most brilliant thing about the Rule of Two was the fact that the only way an apprentice could become the Dark Lord is by killing his own master. By doing so, it raises the ambition of the apprentice. It makes them work hard. It makes them desire power. they want that power that their master has, and they will do anything to do it, and literally anything. By requiring the apprentice to be able to surpass his master, it means that the next Dark Lord of the Sith will be incredibly powerful and will be able to continue the Sith legacy and to be able to finally bring the grand plan to fruition. In contrast, however, the one Sith was the idea that there was only the one Sith, that there was the Order itself, but in reality, it really was about Darth Krayt. Darth Krayt expected absolute loyalty out of his followers, and he, to an extent, believed that they would give it to him, which is why he was actually caught off guard when he was nearly killed by Darth Werelock III. However, this idea of absolute loyalty is not without its flaws, and even though he did have the loyalty of many of his followers, such as Darth Talon and Darth Nihil, he did not understand that this was not the way of the Sith. Absolute loyalty does not breed ambition. It does not breed this idea of having a more powerful Sith to take on the legacy, like with the Rule of Two. This is in fact counterintuitive to Sith philosophy, which puts all the influence on the individual. The Sith code itself says that through strength I gain power. It doesn't talk about the multitude, it doesn't talk about the order, it talks about the individual. Talks about the individual's power and their ability to gain more power. It talks about their ability to free themselves, not free the leader, not free the order. It talks about the personal ability of the individual. And Krayt did not understand this. Krayt looked at it as his own power, as his ability to gain power, not through the ambition of his followers, but through his own ambition, through his own glory, through gaining the loyalty of everyone he could, and then stepping on them. Darth Bane recognized this. He recognized that this was the way of the Sith, which I believe is why he created the Rule of Two like he did. He even, through holocron form, criticized Darth Krayt for having abandoned this idea, for having decided that he was the ultimate form of the Sith. This, I believe, is probably the greatest argument against Darth Krayt and against the Rule of One. In the end, the Rule of Two is the superior form of the Sith Order. Its influence is still being felt in the Star Wars universe through the actions of Darth Kydus, through the actions of Lumia. Heck, even the Lost Tribe followed the Rule of Two, not in actual letter, but in spirit, by instead of attacking through military force, it took over the Alliance through infiltration, much like the Rule of Two did. The One Sith did not understand this, and It was detrimental to their plans, and in fact, actually, they were considered the weakest incarnation of the Sith Order, and I doubt that's going to change. The truth is, probably if Legends continues in some form or another, I think what they need to do is reinstate the Rule of Two. This is what needs to be done. This is what needs to be done in order to continue the Sith legacy, to give it back its strength, to return it to the golden age that Darth Bane brought. This is just my opinion. I've always believed that the Sith are highly adaptive and are able to overcome any possible obstacle that have been put in their way. Well, I hope you liked my video, and I plan to make another one in the near future. This one will be another Versus series video. I'm not going to give it away just yet. I do have something very special planned. I am fairly certain that it has never been done before in a Versus series. But I'm going to keep that under my hat for the moment. So I hope you look forward to that in the coming future. Also, I want to thank my friend, the original Game Bug, who provided the intro video, and I plan to use it in all future videos. So, just see you next time, and have a good day.